several governments to do this, and to start with, you've been to Germany.
Yeah, it seems that we could be moving towards a biometric CCTV sort of state, and one of the places where it's first happening, which may surprise you, is in Berlin.
Catching a train in the German capital today means you may be caught on CCTV, perhaps while stamping your paper ticket. Neither system automatically tracks your movements. At the very least, that requires human intervention. But arrive at Südkreuz in the south of the city, and your face will be scanned and analysed by computers. The testing of facial recognition systems began here last month, but the authorities aren't looking for criminals just yet.
And they're not really looking for me either. Around 200 volunteers have had their faces scanned and been given a location tracker, so the authorities know when they pass through here, and they can see how often the cameras can pick them up just by looking at their faces. If the system's accurate enough, then the next stage would be to use it much more widely, which for many people here would be a breach of their privacy, being constantly monitored with no easy opt-out.
The Germans have a history of being watched. This old US listening station in Berlin was how the West kept tabs on East Germany. On the ground below, first the Nazis and then the Stasi in East Germany kept files on the population filled by informants. So since the fall of the Berlin Wall in 1989 and the decommissioning of ID checkpoints, Berliners have been fiercely protective of their privacy. What's changed is that a new threat has replaced the old. Police control the crowds in the aftermath of a terrorist attack. A truck has mowed down shoppers at a Christmas market in Berlin. 12 are killed and more than 50 injured. At this time, CCTV is still not widely used in public areas. But 3 months later, in March this year, the government passes new laws to extend their use, and the face recognition pilot was given the go-ahead. Despite the trial offering a white route that passengers can take to avoid the cameras, both the country's data commissioner and its top lawyers have expressed concern about Germany moving towards a surveillance state. No one is saying facial recognition couldn't help catch criminals, but the public doesn't seem to have been asked. As Germany goes to the polls this weekend, one member of the coalition who has been in power told me he wasn't consulted about the trial and the technology hasn't been properly debated in Parliament.
It doesn't bring more security. It is just collecting data and more and more, and don't know who, when, where this data may be used. It is a pill they try to give to the people, which doesn't have any effect because it doesn't solve the problems.
Proponents of the scheme point to the dip in crime on Berlin's metro system following the installation of CCTV back in 2011. We did ask both the German Interior Ministry and the police authorities in Berlin for an interview and to take a look at the technology, but both declined. So we asked a few travellers.
I don't trust these systems. I don't trust this new development. Like, everybody should be tracked and everybody should be scanned by cameras.
They showed in TV that if you have a base cap or sunglasses that it doesn't work anymore, so maybe not so much. But anyway, if it catches one, we are very happy.
If it really shows that it will help, then I will be okay with this. In the hope that there is no misuse and now tracking, just collecting tracking data.